2013 MotoGP season sees one of the most significant changes to the championship in recent years. From this year, the first three free practice sessions will be timed, with the combined classification deciding which qualifying session a rider takes part in. The top 10 are automatically put into the so-called Q2, whilst those below head into the preceding Q1. The top two riders from Q1 will then move into Q2, with the 12 riders fighting it out to decide the front part of the grid.
The new qualifying format for MotoGP is, there's two reasons. One is for excitement, for the show. It's separated qualifyings that the fastest group runs together and the slower group runs together. It's one thing, it's for the show. And the other really big reason is it's for safety, for the riders. Each rider group will get a clearer racetrack and be better able to do their best lap time. What we've done is taken what was an existing 1 hour qualifying session, and all we've done is split that up into 30 minutes of free practice and then two times 15 minutes of out and out qualifying. So in effect, the amount of track time is the same. The end of the qualifying session where the riders tried for their best lap is more or less the same. We've just defined those times.
I think it will be good, mainly for the people, for the spectator, because it's 15 minutes that everybody will be on the time attack. The track will be more clear than the last year because we'll be only 12 bikes in the last session, and it will be very, very exciting. We'll use the three practice to get the good setting, and then probably we'll use the last free practice to make a long run, just to check the race situation. It's not exactly the race distance, but it's half an hour, it should be enough, and then we'll prepare for the time attack.
Probably what we will have is more chances to have a clear lap. Then sometimes this can be positive, sometimes this can be negative, you know, but I will say, you know, let's see how it performs in Qatar, and then we will be capable to really make a judgment. And then the main thing is going to be how to use the tires, as you said, you know. Likely we are going to get one extra tire, probably on the soft spec, so then this will help to manage all the sessions we are going to have. But I will say it is helping us to get these three qualifying times. Until now they were free practice, and now if you are lacking one practice, you have the chance to really get on the right lap times, on the second one trying to be on the right qualifying time. So I will say this will give us more chances to really be where we deserve.
Usually we're using two soft tires for the class qualifying session, I mean for lap time attack, but now with 15 minutes I think it will be very tight, and on some track you must sure change your strategy how you do the practice. You need this free practice before the qualifying, because it's also an afternoon session, you know, the track temperature is similar to the race, and sure everybody will need this 30 minutes to skier.
Yeah, I think it's quite an interesting idea. It'll make it more exciting, maybe for people at home watching, make it more exciting for us, because it'd be a little bit more pressure for the first to get into that group and be in that session. I think from a TV time point of view, it's really good for the CRT teams, because we get maybe more quality TV time during the prime qualifying hour, and this is quite good for the sponsorship. It really helps teams like us out that are really struggling to get some money in and all that sort of thing. If we do a really good job on the first three practices, then we could maybe sneak into Q2, which would be really good. And also it gives you a lot of incentive to push right from the start. So sometimes, you know, riders think, okay, I'm gonna leave it till the last 5 minutes, where they really haven't got that option anymore. They've got to go out and push right from the very beginning and be right there at the end of those sessions.
The reaction so far up and down the paddock has been positive, especially the riders. They're really looking forward to it. The teams that we spoke to, consulted in the beginning, are quite happy, because as I said, for them, the amount of track time and when they would plan to do their fastest lap is more or less the same.